In this tutorial, I will be walking through how to build the retail SDK and what is the setup required. There are two main steps. One is to set the default build path to Visual Studio 2017. And second is it requires four setups which needs to be installed. And after that, you restart the environment, and that's all needed for Retail SDK to be built. In this demonstration, we will be building a Retail SDK on a new environment downloaded from LCS. As a first step, I will go to the CMD command line and open it in administrative mode. Then switch to K drive and move to the Retail SDK folder, which is Retail SDK. Once I'm there, I would copy the command which I've already kept for convenience in the notepad, which is ms build rebuild, and it is used to rebuild the SDK. Now you can see here it is using the default .NET build version, and that is what we don't need. Either we use the Visual Studio command line for 2017 to build the SDK, or we can set up the default path variable in the environment variable to make it work on use the default SDK S15. Now you can see there are 72 errors, and there is some setup required to make this work, and in this video I will go over one by one all these setups to resolve these errors. So as a first step, I will go and change the default variable of the path in the environment variable. So in order to do that, I will copy this path, which is pointing to the build exe for version 15.9. I will go to System, Advanced System Settings, click on Environment Variable, and find path, click edit, and put the path here by clicking new and pasting the path, and at the end we need a forward slash which was missing in the text file, so edit that, press OK, and now we will be testing it by copying the command ms build slash version. I will again go to command line, paste that command, and you are seeing it is still using the default .NET build version, so something was not right. I will go back again and click on advanced setting, environment variable, path, edit, and move this path to the top. So retest, and it is still showing the same, so we'll restart it. Okay, now it is using the version 15. This is the version we need for Retail SDK to be built properly. This is the first step done. Now, as a second step, we will need some setups file. And before that, I will go and show you where it is located and confirm that this is the version, 15.9 we are pointing to make it work safe. When you use it from Visual Studio, this is the exe which is getting used, but we are making it here default. So again, testing, running the rebuild command, to see what impact changing the path variable has done. And you can see instead of 72 errors, now we are seeing only two errors, and it is saying that the SDK is not supported and we need to install those SDK. For convenience, I have copied the URL for the setup which is needed, which can also be found on the retail doc site. Basically, I've clicked on them one by one and saved the URL in my notepad. I can also paste that in the video details for convenience. And now, one by one, we will go and install these setup. So copying the first URL. And the first URL is for .NET Core 2.0 SDK. Let's download it. Okay, install. It will take some time. Okay, it's almost complete. Yep, it got completed. Let's move to the second URL and the setup needed for SDK. Install this as well. Close. Now go to the fourth one. That was quick. Let's rerun. We might also need TypeScript version 2.2. And you can get this from Visual Studio 2017, going to the tools and feature and selecting this feature and installing it. And we will be doing that. So I will open Visual Studio 2017. It will first ask me to update it. It will take some time. So in between, I will be pausing the video. So it is almost there. Okay, it is done. Now I will click on Modify. Click on Individual Component, Find TypeScript 2.2. Just confirming that it was 2.2 and to make sure that I get the right version. Yep. Now I'm clicking on Modify to get this installed. It is installed. Now I will restart the environment and click on update and restart. And after that, we will again try it to build the SDK. So the system has restarted and now I'm again pasting the ms build rebuild command. And you can see that it is using version 15.9 as shown earlier, and it is progressing. It is taking some time, which is a good sign. It will take some time to build the SDK, and I will be pausing the video in between just to save time. Still building. As you can see now, it is moving further along after doing all the setup. So now you can see that the errors are gone, only showing 44 warnings and zero error. And this is how you can build the retail SDK for Dynamics 365 for commerce.